In this video, we're going to continue on with the free KutaSoftware website worksheet, Solving Quadratic Equations by Factoring. Picking up where we left off with number 17, I'm going to start by subtracting 3 from both sides. So I'll have 7k squared minus 6k plus 0 equal to 0. Now I'm going to rewrite this as 7k squared minus 6k equal to 0. And what I'm going to do now, I'm going to pull out a common term from each of these. I'll pull out k. So doing so will leave me with 7k minus 6, and there I have my factored quadratic. Because when I distribute that k back in, I'll get 7k squared minus 6k. So I'm either going to have k equal to 0 or 7k minus 6 equal to 0. So one of those solutions is that k equals 0. The other solution, 7k minus 6 equal to 0, I'll add 6 to both sides to get that 7k equals positive 6. And when I divide by 7, I'll get that k equals 6 sevenths. So my two solutions and number 17 for this quadratic are 6 sevenths and 0. Let's move on to number 18. In number 18, I'll subtract 4 from both sides. That way my quadratic equals 0 and I can solve by factoring. So I'll have 35k squared minus 22k plus 7 minus 4, which is 3, and that's equal to 0. Now I can't simplify these terms anymore, so I'm going to need to factor by grouping since my a is greater than 1. Now if you get confused, I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access another free KutaSoftware website worksheet that I've done just on factoring by grouping. And in that worksheet, I go more in depth with that method. So if you need a refresher on how to factor by grouping, click that link below before you jump into this. I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me a times c, which is 35 times 3, but also add to give me 22. 35 times 3 is 105. So what two numbers multiply to give me a positive 105 and add to give me negative 22? Now working through the factors of 105, two factors that will work for me are 7 and 15. If both of those are negative, they'll add to give me a negative 22. So I'll rewrite negative 22k as a negative 15k and a negative 7k. Since negative 15k plus negative 7k equals negative 22k, or subtracting a positive 22k, and then I need to add 3, and that's all equal to 0. Now I'll group the first two terms together and the last two terms together, pulling out a common term from each. In the first grouping, I'll be able to pull out a 5k. So I'll be left with 7k minus 3. And then in the second grouping, I'll pull out a negative 1. So then I'll have 7k minus 3 again. And that all equals 0. So now I have my factors, 5k minus 1 and 7k minus 3. So rewriting this as 5k minus 1 times 7k minus 3, I'll be able to solve my quadratic. And the solutions occur when 5k minus 1 equals 0 or when 7k minus 3 equals 0. So if 5k minus 1 equals 0, I'll add 1 to both sides to get that 5k is equal to a positive 1. And then I'll divide by 5 to get that k is equal to 1 fifth. Now for 7k minus 3 equal to 0, I'll add 3 to both sides to get that 7k equals a positive 3. And when I divide by 7, I'll get that k equals 3 sevenths. So my solutions are 1 fifth and 3 sevenths for number 18. So k equals 1 fifth and k equals 3 sevenths. That will solve this quadratic. Moving on to number 19, in order to factor, I'll start by pulling out a common term, and I can pull out an x from both of these. So I'll have x times 7x plus 2 equal to 0. Because this equation was already equal to 0, I didn't have to manipulate it by moving terms to one side or another. So my factors are x and 7x plus 2. So I need to see when x is equal to 0 and when 7x plus 2 equals 0. Those will be my solutions. So 1 is already given to us, x equals 0. The other one, 7x plus 2 equals 0. We'll solve for x by subtracting 2 from both sides to get 7x equal to negative 2. And then when I divide by 7, I'll get that x equals negative 2 sevenths. So my solutions in number 19 are negative 2 sevenths and 0. Let's move on to number 20. In number 20, I'm going to move two terms to the left-hand side. So I'm going to subtract 27b from both sides. And I'm also going to add 18 to both sides. So I'll have 0 on my right-hand side and 10b squared minus 27b plus 18 on my left-hand side. That is equal to 0. Now I cannot simplify this any further, so I'm going to need to multiply a to c, which is 10 times 18, which equals 180, and then I'll see what two numbers multiply to give me 180 and add to give me negative 27. And looking at the factors of 180, I know that two factors that will accomplish that goal for me are 15 and 12. If both of them are negative, I'll get a negative 27. So I'll rewrite this quadratic as 10b squared plus negative 15b plus negative 12b plus 18, and that all is equal to 0. So negative 15b plus negative 12b still equals that negative 27b. So now I'll group my first two terms together and my last two terms and pull out the GCF, or greatest common factor. In the first two terms, I'll pull out 5b. So that'll leave me with 2b minus 3. And in order to get 2b minus 3 in the second two terms, I'll pull out a negative 6. So now my two factors are 5b minus 6 and 2b minus 3. So 5b minus 6 times 2b minus 3 equals 0, and it also equals 10b squared minus 27b plus 18, since those are equivalent. So now I just need to see when 5b minus 6 equals 0 and when 2b minus 3 equals 0. So here we'll have 5b minus 6 equal to 0, and here we'll have 2b minus 3 equal to 0. In this first equation, I'll add 6 to both sides to get that 5b is equal to a positive 6, and when I divide by 5, I'll get that b is equal to 6 fifths. In that second equation, I'll add 3 to both sides to get that 2b is equal to 3, and then when I divide by 2, I'll get that b is equal to 3 halves. So my solutions in number 20 are 6 fifths and 3 halves. Now on to number 21, I'll start by adding 59x to both sides. So I'll get 8x squared plus 59x plus 21 equal to 0. And I cannot simplify this, so again, I'm going to take my a term and multiply it by c, so that's 8 times 21, which equals 168, and I'm going to see what two numbers multiply to give me 168, and add to give me 59. So I know two factors of 168 that add to give me 59, and that's 3 and 56. So I'm going to rewrite this quadratic as ax squared plus 3x plus 56x plus 21 equals 0. 3x plus 56x equals 59x. So I haven't changed the value. It's still equivalent. Now I'm going to group the first two terms together and the second two terms together, pulling out the GCF, greatest common factor of each. And the first one, it's x, so I'll have 8x plus 3. In the second grouping, the GCF is 7, so I'll have 8x plus 3, and that's equal to 0. So I'll have x plus 7 times 8x plus 3. That is equal to 0. So I need to see when x plus 7 equals 0 and when 8x plus 3 equals 0. So x plus 7 equals 0 when, by subtracting 7 from both sides, I'll get x equal to negative 7. And for 8x plus 3 equal to 0, I'll subtract 3 from both sides to get that 8x equals negative 3, and then divide both sides by 8 to get x equal to negative 3/8. So my solutions for number 21 are -3/8 and -7. Now lastly in this video, I'll go over number 22. If you haven't done so before this point, click that like button and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. Now that hopefully you've done that, let's go over number 22. I'll subtract 3 from both sides and add 7a to both sides. So subtracting 3 and adding 7a. That'll give me 15a squared plus 4a minus 3 equal to 0. Now this cannot be simplified any further, so I'm going to take a and c and multiply them, 15 times negative 3, which equals negative 45. So I need to see what two numbers multiply to give me negative 45 and add to give me a positive 4. Well, off the top of my head, I know that 9 times 5 equals 45, and when 5 is negative, I'll get a positive 4 when I add those two together. So I'll rewrite this quadratic as 15a squared minus 5a plus 9a minus 3, and that's equal to 0. Negative 5a plus 9a equals positive 4a. So grouping my first two terms together and my last two terms together, I'll pull out a 5a from the first two terms to get 3a minus 1, and then I'll pull out 3 from the next two terms to get 3a minus 1 again. So now my factors are 5a plus 3 and 3a minus 1. Those are equal to 0. So in order to solve, I need to see when each of those equals 0. 5a plus 3 equal to 0 and 3a minus 1 equal to 0. Solving for a, I'll subtract 3 from both sides from 5a plus 3 equal to 0 to get that 5a equals negative 3. And when I divide by 5, I'll get that a equals negative 3/5. And for my second equation, 3a minus 1 equals 0, I'll add 1 to both sides to get that 3a equals positive 1. And when I divide by 3, I get that a equals 1/3. So my last solutions on this worksheet are 1/3 and negative 3/5. And with that, I wrap up this video and this worksheet. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And if you didn't do so before this problem, remember to like, subscribe, and share this video with your peers.